Greetings, I'm Mr. Spiffy, and welcome to the bottom of the barrel. Tomorrow is SummerSlam, and this will be the fifth SummerSlam to take place at the Staples Center in Los Angeles, California. And the fifth SummerSlam I have not been able to travel to, despite the fact that it's in my home fucking state. I would love to be able to travel down to SummerSlam. It's just, August always seems to be a really shitty time of year for me when it comes to money and being able to travel or take time off or do stuff. And while I got plenty of time off right now because I'm still in limbo on my job situation, I don't have a steady form of income outside of unemployment, which is still about $400 less than what I'm used to making. So, you know, you kind of have to pick and choose your battles. That being said, let's at least talk about tomorrow's SummerSlam, which I will be happily enjoying at my friend Robin's house tomorrow afternoon. And I'll give you my rundown and thoughts on this upcoming event. We're going to have a pre-show matchup. The pre-show is going to be 1 hour long, so for those of you who, you know, make sure you tune in at 4 o'clock Pacific, that's 7 p.m. Eastern time, to make sure that you're there on time to actually see the pre-show in its entirety. I know the pre-show's not always all that extremely entertaining, but there is a good match on there, RVD versus Dean Ambrose. And I expect that RVD will win this matchup. He will not become the United States champion. I don't believe that. But I do believe that he'll win it by disqualification. He's going to come within an eyelash of becoming U.S. champion. The Shield's going to jump in, attack him. Big Show and Mark Henry are going to come out and probably save RVD. And this will either lead to a rematch from this last Friday where the Shield took on Big Show and RVD, or it'll lead to a tag team title match where Big Show and Mark Henry will challenge the other two members of the Shield, Roman Reigns and Seth Rollins, for the tag team titles. If that match does come about for the tag titles, I expect the Shield to come out on top. Again, though, I probably expect another DQ ending. I know that kind of sucks, but I probably expect Roman Reigns to probably take out like Show with a spear and get the pinfall. We move on to the main matches on the card. Cody Rhodes versus Damian Sandow. Even though Sandow's Mr. Money in the Bank, Mr. Money in the Bank is always held down, and I expect Cody Rhodes to actually pick up the win over this one because this will be his big moral victory and begin the beginning of a push for Cody Rhodes. Damian Sandow still will go on to become world champion, and actually, Cody Rhodes going over Damian Sandow now is good because that could put Cody Rhodes right in the thick of things for the World Heavyweight Championship when Sandow finally does cash in and become World Heavyweight Champion, if that's what they want to do with it. We have the Ring of Fire match, which is not actually an Inferno match. It's an Inferno match ring, but you don't actually have to set people on fire. It's something that you've been able to do on the WWE games for a number of years now, and now we get to actually see it in real life. Bray Wyatt taking on Kane. Despite the fact of the stupidity of the fact that you're not trying to set the guys on fire, this match is still going to be good. I hope Bray Wyatt's beard doesn't accidentally catch on fire. That would suck because, yeah, ouch. And I expect Bray Wyatt to probably win this one by pinfall over Kane. No real surprises in that matchup. Alberto Del Rio is defending the World Heavyweight Championship against Christian. I'm actually hoping Christian to come out on top, and that's who I'm predicting to win and become the new World Heavyweight Champion. I think Christian deserves it, and I think he deserves a serious title reign. And I don't believe Damian Sandow will cash in at SummerSlam. We have a mixed tag team matchup. Dolph Ziggler and Caitlyn taking on Biggie Langston and AJ Lee. I expect Ziggler and Caitlyn to probably win this one. Biggie and AJ are just on the low end of the stick right now, and they are constantly getting knocked down. And I'm expecting that this is going to lead to AJ is going to do something stupid that's going to cost them the matchup, and this is finally going to get Big E to break away from AJ Lee. And I want AJ Lee needs to kind of be on her own for a bit, and Big E, he needs to actually switch over to his gimmick from NXT and start doing the five count thing, because he, you know, that can get over with the fans, and him just doing the getting really violent and stuff like that. And as long as he's beating up on the right guys, it works. We have another Divas match involved. The Total Divas match, Brie Bella with her sister in her corner taking on Natalya with the Funkadactyls in her corner. Oh yeah, and Eva Marie will be over in the other corner. A lot of shenanigans I expect to fall into this matchup, but considering the push of everything, I actually expect Natty to come out on top of this one. I think Natalya deserves it, and I think Natalya should be heading towards the Divas Championship with AJ Lee, and I think this would be good for her to get that moral victory over top. The faces of the Divas division would be nice to see, and that's who I'm voting on. I'm voting on Natty to win. Let me take a quick thought here. Let's see. No Intercontinental title matchup. CM Punk versus Brock Lesnar. This is one of those matches that's the best versus the beast is one of the hardest ones to call. And after a lot of soul searching, I've come to two potential, there are three potential outcomes. I really can't make a decision. On a forum board where I had to make a decision, I chose Brock Lesnar to win, and I'm still very iffy on that. There's also the possibility that CM Punk will get like an inside cradle win over Brock Lesnar, not a solid victory over him, and Lesnar will beat the holy hell out of him after the match is over. The third possibility, which I see being more likely, is that this will end in a a no contest, where it's a double disqualification, where both men just are beating on each other with chairs and stuff like that, and the referee can't keep control, and the referee throws the match out. Because this match is not a no disqualification matchup, so that's a very conceivable possibility, and also helps, you know, doesn't really hurt either man, and builds towards the possibility of a rematch. But doing that at SummerSlam, I'm not entirely sure. I think that this feud is the best possibility of continuing if Brock Lesnar wins. And Brock Lesnar, if he wins, is not going to be a clean victory by any marker. It's going to be like Heyman cheating totally. Probably even something as simple as like Brock, CM Punk going to suplex Brock and from the outside, and Heyman like grabbing his foot, kind of like the Ultimate Warrior ravishing Rick Rude finish back from WrestleMania 5. Something along that nature. So I'm looking for Lesnar to win, but, you know, I'll be perfectly happy with the outcome of CM Punk wins. It's just, you know, that is what it is. Okay, of course, there's the WWE let me make sure I've got all this. We had the two Divas matches, Ring of Fire, Ambrose and RVD, the World Heavyweight Championship match. Here. I know I'm missing something here. Somebody throw me a bone here. She doesn't know. Oh yeah, and Damian was. So, yeah. Okay, so I think. Oh, hang on. So, Damian and Cody, the two matches with the Divas, Ambrose and RVD, the World Heavyweight Championship match, Punk versus Brock, and Ring of Fire match. So, yeah, okay, I've covered everything. So, last match. WWE Championship, John Cena versus Daniel Bryan. Cena is hurt. His elbow needs surgery. It's sticking out. It looks weird. It looks like it's something that he could use to fuck his girlfriend with, just like, elbow shots! Yeah, it's kind of grody, but dildo-esque at the same time. I expect that Bryan will win. Now, how he wins, I don't know if it'll be a pin. I don't think it'll be him making John Cena tap out. I don't think Cena is going to really give him the tap out victory. It would be kind of cool if he did, but I expect it to probably be like a quick inside cradle 1-2-3. I expect Randy Orton to attempt to cash in. Now, when I say the words attempt to cash in, I expect that he's going to come out, he's going to actually hand over the briefcase, he's going to, you know, wail on Daniel for a little bit, he's going to go for an RKO, and somehow or another, Daniel's going to reverse it into like a cradle roll up 1-2-3 out of nowhere. Get Randy Orton. Orton is going. Daniel's going to be happy. He's still the WWE champion. And then Randy's going to nail him with a chair. It's going to be a brutal beatdown to finish off the event because Randy is going to snap. And this is how I would book it. If you're going to make Randy Orton a heel, having him cash in on the most popular guy and win is not. It's a way to do it, but it's so expected and so predictable. You want to do it the right way, you want to really make him over, not only do you have him cash in and lose, giving the fans that moment of yay, but then just have him wail and lay out the champion. And this will lead to them facing each other at next month's pay-per-view. So, you know, I think that's probably going to be the way it's going to go down. I'm keeping my fingers crossed because, you know, I like to be correct. And that's about it. I will be back tomorrow evening after I've gotten home from my friend's house to do my SummerSlam review. Hell, if there's enough lighting in her apartment, I might go ahead and bring my camera along with me and go ahead and shoot the review there. It just depends on how things go. I'm Mr. Spiffy, and this barrel's been scraped clean. I'll see you tomorrow.